Hi, I'm Panice from the Creatives Factory, here to equip you with the right tools and resources to help you understand, protect, and navigate your way in a constantly changing music industry. One of the most awkward parts of collaborating is negotiating splits. You can't register your music without splits settled, and you can't make money without registering your music. Figuring out these splits gets a little awkward and confusing as soon as a second person enters that picture. It's something that every creative needs to navigate. But before we go into that, please make sure you like this video, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell icon to be notified of new videos as soon as they're released. Talk about splits is by giving different scenarios of my two talented and creative friends, Teddy and Froggy. Here's scenario one. Teddy writes the lyrics, music, and produces his song. Not bad, Teddy. He owns 100% of that song. Scenario two. Teddy and Froggy write a song together. Teddy writes the music, Froggy writes the lyrics. They produce it together. They both decide to do a 50-50 split. Teddy owns 50, Froggy owns the other 50. Scenario three, Teddy and Froggy write a song together. Teddy writes the music and verse two lyrics. Froggy writes the rest of the lyrics. Teddy proposes that Teddy should get 75% and Froggy should get 25%. Froggy disagrees. Verse two isn't as long as verse one. So Froggy says Teddy should get 60% and Froggy should get 40%. Things get a little awkward. Now would be a great time to introduce Froggy and Teddy to Audley. Audley is an online music platform for creatives where you can negotiate splits without being face to face. It's also perfect for the collaborative session because you can upload song ideas as you go and make lyric changes. You can access Audley on their website, audley.com, or get the app, which is perfect for being on the go. Scenario four, Teddy and Froggy write a song together and they hire me to produce it. Now this can go a few different ways. I produce the song and I don't make any changes to the music or lyrics. Since they paid me, I don't own the master recording. They do. And whatever composition split they've decided between themselves. Now, let's say I help rework some of the arrangement as I'm producing. I'm making music and lyric changes. Since they paid me, I still don't own the master recording, but now I'm included in the split for the composition. However, up until now, we've been talking about independence. But another variation is, let's say, a record label or a production company, creative house, manager, or any other type of investor wants to invest in Teddy and Froggy as songwriters. Whomever invests in making the song happen becomes the master owner, and whoever was involved in creating that song still splits the composition. So an example here would be Teddy, Froggy, and I all split the composition. And our record label, or our production house, which is the Creatives Factory, owns the master. Now another scenario is Teddy and Froggy hit me up as a producer and they want to collab. I'm down. We have a writing session and we start the song from scratch. Since they didn't hire me and this is a collaboration, I split the master recording with them. Also, we wrote the song all together from scratch, so we all split the composition. Scenario five, I post a snippet of a dope beat on Instagram and Teddy hears it. He hits me up and he wants to buy it. Now this can also go a few different ways. Let's start with the least expensive option. I can lease the beat to Teddy. Now since this is non-exclusive, this means Froggy can also use that same beat and make a song. In this case, I own the master recording and I get a composition split with whoever uses my beat. Teddy hits me up and says he doesn't want Froggy or anybody to use that beat. So I lease it to him exclusively. Here, I still own the master and I share composition splits with Teddy. Now, something to note with exclusive beat licensing is that sometimes there's an agreed upon time frame, which means that that beat is only exclusive for X amount of time. So in this case, let's just say a year. So my beat is exclusive to Teddy for a year, but after a year, Froggy can then use my beat and make his own song. Another case is where Teddy wants to own the master. I sell the beat to Teddy and he gets it exclusively. Here, Teddy owns the master, but we still share the composition because I still created the music. The most expensive option is Teddy wants it all. He wants the master and he wants 100% of that composition. So he pays me a premium for the entire beat. I become a ghostwriter and I sell the beat to him. Here, he owns the master recording and he owns all of that composition. Yay for Teddy, he has his splits figured out. Now he goes to register his music, but he sees something called a publisher's share. Now he's a little confused because he doesn't have a publisher, but he needs to fill this out to continue his registration. So far, we've only been talking about the writer's share, which is only half of the pie. In our next video, we'll get to the publisher's share and how Teddy can finish his registration if he doesn't have a publisher and what he'd do if he did get a publishing deal. So make sure you tune into our next video to get the other half of that pie. With collaborations, there are so many different scenarios and so many different possibilities. If you're in a place where you need help or guidance, we'd love to talk to you and help you out. We offer consulting at very affordable rates. You can email us or visit our website. Thank you again for watching this video. Make sure you check out our other videos. And also, if this information was helpful to you, like it was for Teddy and Froggy, please make sure you like our video, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell icon to be notified of new videos as soon as they're released.